This is the viscera of the stomach with greater omentum, lesser omentum with its content and esophagus. This is the greater curvature, lesser curvature, and this is cardiac orifice. Cardiac orifice lies 2.5 cm left to the median plane, and the pyloric orifice lies 1.25 cm right to the median plane. And the greater curvature is extending from the cardiac orifice to the pyloric orifice. And this is stomach is situated in the epigastric, left hypochondriac, and umbilical region. Now the parts of the stomach. Parts here from the cardiac orifice, we will give a horizontal line. This horizontal line will divide the stomach from the into the body and the fundus. This is the fundus of the stomach, and from the body body of the stomach, the pylorus of the stomach is divided by a oblique line which is extended from the incisura angularis to the greater curvature. From here we will give a oblique line, and this oblique line will divide the stomach into the body and the pyloric part. And this is the pylorus of the stomach. This is pyloric entrum, and through this there will pass the pyloric canal. Now the posterior relation of the stomach or the stomach bed, it is formed by some relation. There is present some relation. There is a left crest of the diaphragm, and at the midpoint there is tortuous splenic artery, and below the tortuous splenic artery there is pancreas, and above the splenic artery there is left kidney or anterior surface of the left kidney, and above the kidney there is suprarenal gland, and at the lateral side there is impression of the spleen. Impression of the spleen, and at this portion they are present of the left colic flexor or splenic flexor, and there will be transverse mesocolon. Now the artery supply. Artery is supplied by this lesser curvature is supplied by the anastomosis of the left gastric artery and right gastric artery. Left gastric artery, it is a branch of the celiac trunk which is present in this portion, and right gastric artery, it is a branch of the hepatic artery. This is the greater curvature. Greater curvature is supplied by the anastomosis of the left gastroepiploic artery and right gastroepiploic artery. And left gastroepiploic artery, it is a branch of the splenic artery, and right gastroepiploic artery, it is a branch of the gastroduodenal artery. And gastroduodenal artery is again branch of the hepatic artery, and hepatic artery branch of the celiac trunk. And this fundus of the stomach, this portion is supplied by 3 or 4 short gastric artery, which is the branch of the left gastroepiploic artery and branch of the splenic artery. And posterior part of the fundus is supplied by posterior gastric artery, and this is the branch of the tortuous splenic artery. And now the now this is the greater curvature. Here we'll attach the greater omentum, and this greater omentum has 4 layer, and its first layer it will contain the anastomosis of the left gastroepiploic artery and the right gastroepiploic artery. And this is the lesser omentum, and lesser omentum contain the anastomosis of the left gastric artery and the right gastric artery. And in left gastric artery, this is the attached margin, and the other margin is it will be present at the liver level in J shape. Now this is the cut section of the stomach. If we cut the stomach along the greater curvature, then we will find some structure. This is the rugi. This rugi, it is the mucus fold, and through this here will open the gastric pit. Through this gastric pit will open the gastric gland, and along the medial or lesser curvature there will present the gastric canal. And this is the esophageal cardiac opening, and this is the pyloric opening. Pyloric opening of the stomach will lies here, and if we palpate this pyloric part, then we can find that it is a little bit hard than the cardiac orifice. Cardiac orifice is a little bit smooth, and this is the overall cut section.